This is me fighting against Fuelweaver, but I'm only using ChatGPT. If you've been living under a rock the past couple of years, it's an AI chatbot that was trained on data from the entire internet, and it knows pretty much everything there is. Well, at least it should. It knows where your dad is, it can do your homework for you, it will take over the world in a couple of years, but can it be the final boss of Don't Starve, Ancient Fuelweaver? Let's find out. I picked default Wilson and spawned in, but before doing anything, I first have to ask ChatGPT what to do. I just spawned in Don't Starve together, and I want to defeat the Ancient Fuelweaver. What's the step one to doing that?
The first step to defeating the Ancient Fuelweaver in Don't Starve Together is to prepare and gather necessary resources and gear. This involves a few key tasks.
Establish a stable base, set up resources and secure rich base where you can supply essential vitamins. Other basic resources. For now, my goals are pretty simple. I just want to gather a lot of grass and twigs and explore as much of the world as I can to find all of the important things that I will need.
I hope I don't have... Yes, that's all the resources I need. Look,
I already started off pretty strong by finding a pig village and the cave entrance.
That's the second cave entrance, that's really good.
And I also made a friend.
It's nice that they have a lot of grass, but the twigs, they should get some more twigs as well. I love friend, I love you too. What is your name? You're Barley. You is good, bro. You're the best, you're the best, you're my little pookie.
The first couple of days weren't very interesting, as pretty much all I did was just walking around the world.
I hope he doesn't fight these.
Finding some things.
Yeah, I'm gonna make a trap to mark the statue.
And gathering different resources that I'll need for my base later on.
Oh, what do you mean home time? I think he's actually going home. Okay, I can make an axe and already start gathering this. Well, he didn't say anything about hunts. So I'm not gonna do it. I'm not allowed to by my master, which is ChatGPT. At some point in the future, I'm probably gonna be saying that unironically because, you know, the robot invasion and all that. Let's just hope it doesn't happen. Let's make a pickaxe and let's use the fire. Look, it's a tall bird. Oh, you already angry. Don't angry, bro. Don't angry, bro. Don't angry, bird. Fuck! Look, picking. That's nice. Oh, he's right here. That's even nicer. One thing I could find here is the pan flute. Yeah, I found it. I can get some logs as well, so I can get a full stack. Take that, nature. Let's try the wormhole. If it... It took me from here. Wait. This wormhole sucks. Don't attack me. You racist! Goblin! You racist goblin!
Wait, I'll use the torch.
You think you're the main character, I know you think that. But you're not. And you're gonna burn alive. Let's try this. But I misclicked. This is not bad, this is the triple mech task biome.
This is not the triple mech task biome, but there is still mech task, and that's pretty good.
This is a swamp, and the thing with the swamp is that it often has a desert on the other side. I'm not convinced there has to be something here.
And there actually was.
Oh! No, no. You're banned, get out. If you're gonna start fighting a beast, yeah. I call it. Look, there's a. Oh, it's gonna be fun getting. Carrying this marble. That one's gonna be really fun to get. Oh, yes, this is the Oasis Desert. Well, the two deserts next to each other is honestly the greatest thing. I mean, it's not next to each other, but they are very close. Oh, that's the final suspicious marble. I have all of them, I think. Let's be honest, this won't lead anywhere. This is just gonna loop around. Yeah, that was useless. No, you know what? Fuck it. I honestly... What I can do is this. I can make a raft like this and then cross this. Cross it like this.
On day 6, I found pretty much all the things I needed, and I decided to make my base in the Dragonfly Desert, put the Oasis Desert right next door, as well as a swamp, a wormhole, and a cave entrance. It had pretty much everything I would ever need, and even picking is easily accessible through 2 pairs of wormholes. And I think that my master would approve too.
Number 1. Proximity to resources. Choose a location near abundant resources like trees, rocks, and food sources. Number 2. Safety. Ensure it's not too close to dangerous areas like swamps, spider dens, or hostile biomes. Number 3. Access to important biomes. Ideally, it should be within reasonable distance to essential biomes like the savanna, deciduous forest, and swamp.
Which he does. What I need to do right now is to decide on how the base will be set up.
Not the best, but it works.
And then just gather the resources and build everything. First, I got some wood.
Abuse pig labor. They've also tricked me into selling my soul to the cartel.
Then I accidentally killed the tree guard.
Excuse me? Come on. Come on. There we go.
And finally built the main things like an alchemy engine, a few chests, and a farm. I broke the game while trying to change some settings.
Oh, what happened? Damn it.
And after I fixed the resolution, I went to dig up some grass and twigs.
God damn it.
This is one thing that ChatGPT did not mention, but as it is a staple in literally every single base, I had no choice but to put them there. Then I got some gears for an icebox, built a lightning rod, got Glomer from Pig King.
Please tell me it's the right one. It is! Glomer, it's you!
And built a small pig farm. Next I got a lot of rocks, and I finished the base by building more chests and crockpots, and adding some trims to make it look a little bit better. After checking ChatGPT,
alchemy engine, crockpot, icebox, chest, lightning rod, prompts, I have that. Fruit, meats, vegetables and berries. I don't have berries. Honey.
I was still missing one thing. I broke some beehives to get the whatever this is called, and I built some bee boxes. And with that, the first step is done. Now, step 2 is rushing the ruins and killing Ancient Guardian for the Ancient Key. I'm also apparently supposed to get the key to the city, which is exclusive to Hamlet. That's a pretty big mistake that ChatGPT made, and I will be counting all the mistakes that it makes from now on. First, I needed to prepare a little bit by getting some monster meat and feeding it to the pigs to transfer them into warpigs and then killing them to just get the meat and pig skin which I can use to make football helmets and a new hand bat, and then just getting some tools. Basically, I got these things. That's all that matters. That was essentially everything I needed for the ruins. Then I also made a bit of pierogi and the thermostone because it's winter. That's right, it's already day 21 and I'm probably taking a lot more time than I should be. But also, I don't know, I'm bad, I don't have a good excuse. But now I have to find the ruins. And ChatGPT gave me probably the worst guide for finding the ruins that exists. First, I have to locate a sinkhole. Then enter the caves and explore carefully. Then find the ruins entrance. Blue mushrooms and ancient statues are a good indicator. Yeah, ancient statues are good because when you see them, you're in the ruins. It doesn't help at all. Basically, what you have to do is look for these stone paths, which lead you out of the grass biome and into different biomes, and specifically, you're looking for the money biome. The blue and red mushroom forests are pretty helpful because they're always connected directly to the main money biome. Explore it a bit to see the areas where there's mostly light bulbs and where there's mostly rocks, and following the split between the two will lead you directly to the ruins. Well, this is how it went for me. First, I came across McDonald's.
Is that?
The first attempt at a trip to the ruins completely sucked because I forgot to take living logs for a star color staff, which I will need. And the second trip went even worse.
I'm going back, it's somewhere over that way. Let's check this out. Okay, based on the split, right, this is mostly light bulbs, this looks like it's mostly the rocks. So this should be the path that's actually following the split and will lead to the ruins. In theory.
Yeah, and that in theory makes a big difference.
What's this? Let's do a crusade. It's the ruins. Wait, no, it's the... That's the stalagmite biome, that's the useless. Let's try to keep exploring, but I think this part... Wait, it might. No, that's going the other way. Nightmare Warpig. Can't move. I don't care. Where the fuck is it gonna be? Not here, apparently. Oh, Glowberry. That could be your That's not it! That's... Another stupid stalagmite biome. There's a touchstone. Looks like it's that way. That's it. Did I find it? Is that it? Could that be it? Bro, if it's it, that's it. Yes! I don't know, I just have to keep going to find it. Damn, this place is a maze. Yo, maybe?
That is a monkey pot, which would normally be an indicator of a monkey village, which would lead me straight to the ruins, but it was just with this one house, and there was literally nothing else that was actually important anywhere around it.
Well, this is definitely not it. Full side fragments. Where the fuck should I be going? Yeah, don't tell me. I have to be out of here, and quickly. Oh. It looks like it's gonna be... Oh! It looks like it's going to be that way. Yeah, but now I have to get back home. I'm low on, low on a lot of things, and I'm not gonna be able to get there in time. Oh no. Oh my, this is way more dramatic than it has any right to be. I mean, a red gem. That's nice. I'll take red gem. Itchy, shut up. I'm almost out. Hello?
But even though the second ship completely sucked, thanks to it I actually knew the general idea of where the ruins will be thanks to the wilds biome, and on the third trip...
Sir, I have a proposition. Would you like to get the car warranty? Or would you like to be fucking broke?
I was able to find the actual village in no time.
Oh, jackpot!
And then, I had quite a fun time looting the ruins.
Could it be? Could it be? That's a bishop, by the way. Smuggles would have been helpful, I'm just... Just saying! Slight fucking issue, god damn it! Not good, not good. I don't think you can get here, so I'm gonna barricade myself here. No! Stop stealing the fire! Right, frazzled wires. Mine it! White, three totally yellow gems.
That's one for the solid color staff and one for the magic luminescence.
What's a cave worm doing here? Bro. Also, no! If you wanna do this, then let's do it. Okay, that one's dead. There's three of them. Where do you keep coming from? Where do you keep coming from? Oh my god. It's dark. There's nothing I can do, really. Oh my. Shit. This is my last helmet.
For now, it looks like I am safe, but the game is still not done trying to make everything worse.
Stop taking away my fire! Stop stealing it! Oh, let's get out!
Okay, so the rest was basically just the same as what you already saw, so I'll just save you the time. Basically, I was trying to get a yellow gem for the magic luminescence. Let's go back to my voiceover. After making the magic luminescence, the star color staff, and most importantly, the full side medallion, it was time to look for Ancient Guardian. The Felicite Medallion shows me the exact location of the Ancient Key, and because it's short by Ancient Guardian, seeing the Ancient Key gives me his exact location.
What? What is it? Oh, that lowers my sanity. Wait. Oh, wrong way. Imagine if I had a lazy explorer. I could have just teleported. Oh! Yeah, fun fact, when you walk on the edge of the spider web, it doesn't cause the spiders. It only does it when you walk more in the middle. Like this. Look how! Damn, that's cool. I think I have to go that way. I don't care if the thermal snow breaks, I honestly don't give a shit. I wanna find it and then I'll back off, warm up with the circle of staff, get my sanity up a little bit, but I'm not gonna go in this state where I'm almost freezing. Wait. Oh, I have to go all the way back. Shit. This is the entrance.
And there he is, the giant round goblin. In the first phase, he charges at you, and when he hits a pillar, he gets stunned for a couple seconds, during which you can hit him.
Okay, one thing. I didn't realize this. Hold on, I have to fix my sanity. Now I can go. Need him to hit the pillars. You hit the pillars, and then you get stunned. Let's go. Alright, we're on to phase 2.
During the second phase, he can also jump at you.
Ay-ay-ay.
And you dodge that by just walking in any direction as far as possible. And sometimes he bleeds, which spawns shadow tentacles, and those can be pretty dangerous.
Why are you running? Damn, I remember this boss fight being kind of hard, like being at least a little bit hard. But holy shit, it's easy. I was just so bad at it. Hey. Noob. There we go. And that's how to survive 100 days and don't starve together.
Now he's dead. But before taking the loot from the chest, you gotta be careful because he spawns a few more shadow tentacles around it, and if you don't pay attention and just try to take the loot, you can kind of die.
Holy shit, that's good!
I took some of the most important things, like another Starcaller staff and of course the Ancient Key, and with that, I killed Ancient Guardian, I have the Ancient Key, and the second step is done. Now, as I was going back to my base, I forgot about Deerclops.
I'm gonna lead him into a swamp. I can't fight him on 13 sanity. Follow me. Oh fuck! Why? Shit. Oh my god! Oh my god, bro. Oh my god. This is going so bad right now. Oh, yes, well, thank god it's one of these. Yes! Unfortunately, I'm gonna have PTSD from this thing.
Now he's dead. But before moving on to step 3, I decided to take some time and work on my base so that I won't be short of the resources when I need them. I'll just summarize it in 3 sentences. I collected a ton of wood, traded frazzled wires to picking for nearly 3 sacks of gold, made the umbrella, and destroyed a lot of killer beehives.
They're already angry at me, what the fuck?
While building more of my own D-boxes. But a bit more importantly,
Oh my god!
I got dragon fruit from a seed, which means I'll be having a ton of dragon pie in like 10 days. On day 41, I started the third step.
The third step involves defeating the shadow pieces and obtaining the shadow atrium. To summon and defeat the shadow pieces, you need to assemble the three marble statues, bishop, knight, and rook, during a full moon.
According to ChatGPT, the shadow pieces spawn automatically during the dusk of a full moon once the statues are repaired. That's wrong. In reality, they spawn when you mine the repaired statues on the night of a new moon, not a full moon, but I didn't fully know that yet, and it did lead to some confusion later on. But what do I have to do right now? It's easy. There are three statues scattered around the world, which are the Knight Hat, the Bishop Hat, and the Rook Nose. There's also a set piece with marble sculptures for those pieces. I have to bring the statues to that set piece, and then use them to repair the mine sculptures. I already discovered all three of the chest pieces, so all I have to do is carry them all over to that set piece. The first one I decided to move was the Bishop Hat.
Oh my god, that takes time. It doesn't mention a beefalo or anything like that, so I have to carry it by hand. Why is it lowering my sanity? Yeah, it is, because he's fucking weak! Look at this guy! Weak, bro, you weak. I don't think the path even makes a difference. It is a mystery. Oh shit, no! Okay, what I have to do, I have to chop it. I have to care. Oh my! That was uncalled for. I should have used Wolf Gang probably. Yeah. What about it? Why? Who's gonna carry the boats?
And as I got closer, there was a slight issue. Well, there were two of them. The first one was that there were two of them. I carried the Bishop Hat, while there was another Bishop Hat way closer, which I didn't realize was a Bishop Hat, I thought it was something else. So I carried that one for literally no reason. Then I went back to my base to take care of the farm, and look, the dragon fruit is fully grown now. And also a part of my grass farm ran away.
My fucking...
Then I had to carry the Bishop Hat through the swamp.
I somehow need to go through this, without also dying to tentacles. The buff is safe.
I surprisingly didn't get attacked by anything, and in no time, I was able to mine all the statues and use the Bishop Hat to repair the Bishop. And now it was time to move on to the Knight Hat. It was sort of in the same direction that I was already going in, so it was pretty convenient, and I was able to carry that one pretty quickly too. But now it was time for the most tedious part yet. Finding the Rook Nose. From exploring the world, I remember that I found exactly 3 of these chess pieces, and since 2 of them were the bishop, it means that I didn't find the Rook Nose yet, and I have to look for it somewhere that I didn't explore. So I went looking for it.
I don't think there's much here. I don't have that explored. That's really warm almost. Oh, that's actually kind of far. Damn, I explore really fast with the magical medicines and the walking. Also, I realized that even if I explore the whole outline, I might not find the exact pieces. So that makes it a lot harder to find it. Look at Alberdeck. I just saw it right in front of you, and you don't care. Damn, bro. The Talbot mother slept through her child's kidnapping. That's very wrong, isn't it? I know kidnapping is wrong too, but we'll be a good mother and at least try to do something about it. Oh, the Talbot follow me? I don't want to explore the whole thing. Yeah, I'll just explore the outline. Hopefully I find it. If I find it like that, I'll save a lot of time. And if I don't, I'll just explore the rest.
Then when I stopped by my base, this happened.
Yes! No, you eat the seed!
Note to self, don't leave seeds for things that you want on the ground, because birds can eat them. And then I continued looking for the Rook Nose.
I'll keep exploring the world. For the statues, I could check here, that's probably the best thing And if I need to carry it, I throw it in the wormhole, not carry it through the swamp. And that goes far. Then what? I'll check that one part in case. No rook knows. No rook knows. No rook knows. Did you guys take any shit lately? This one. You took this one. You guys should take a shit in my farm. Why am I going here? I have suspicions of where it could be. I think it's gonna be either here or here. I always see it in grass biomes. I'm gonna explore the full thing because I can't be missing anything. I can't be missing a single piece of information. Nom. Nom. Oh my god, it's the holy pig! Fireflies! Oh, Claudius. Claudius. Claudius! Oh my god, it's Claudius. Claudius. It's him. Oh, in 6 days it's summer. Wait, are you Claudius by any chance? You're not Claudius. Claudius! He kind of looks like a... He looks like a human. In both ways. Wait. It's gonna be here. It's been 45 minutes that I've been trying to file. Oh, that's a knight! I already have a knight! No, bro, no! I don't think it's in this one little piece. Don't tell me it's in the place that I explored, like, at the last one. I'll take this. All these things are to look at. It should be here. I also have no idea where it could be. Where else it would be.
After exploring literally the entire world, I still couldn't find it anywhere. So I checked the map to see if I didn't accidentally miss it at some point.
Just recheck everything. It's not here, not here, not here. It's not in this branch. The next branch. Don't see anything. It could theoretically be there. Nothing. It's a bishop. I fucking am. Actually, that was the rook nose all along. And I completely forgot about it. Oh my god. No, that's... You just can't, bro. You can't prove this.
So yeah, I just wasted a whole hour. I started carrying the rook nose.
One thing I didn't think about is that I need to take the frimstone.
I thought about using the wormhole instead of carrying it through the fucking swamp like last time, and it actually worked.
Please, 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 please. Yes, let's go! Let's go! It works!
And then it was just a home run from there. All of the statues are now repaired, and there are a couple days left until a new moon. So now what? Well, on day 60 I made a ton of dragon pie and a couple of football helmets, and on day 61 it was time to fight. Unfortunately, ChatGPT did give me the wrong information when it comes to summoning them, and I had to look on the wiki to see how to summon them properly. And then I messed it up. I was supposed to mine them on the new moon, not during the dusk before it. ChatGPT, that's your fault, you illegal And not trolling back, I actually started the fight.
Wait.
The bishop is the easiest and should be dealt with first.
I think I'm probably gonna have to be running around here. Just dodging stuff. Bro, I can't see anything like this. Is that the bishop? Oh, he transfers into a projectile and then... Bro, where's the bishop? I can't see it! Never mind, it's kind of easy. It's not that hard, it's just... I don't figure out how it works. Oh, the knight is dead. The bishop is dead. I'm confused by it, I'll just fucking wing it. And where is the knight? I guess I'm killing the rook then. Oh, that's pretty simple. So I didn't even need ChatGPT. That's incredibly easy. Hold on, I need to find the knight. Where is the knight?
Let's just say I lost the knight, so I rolled back again. Let's pretend that first fight never happened and just start over.
The knight is tougher and should be dealt with second.
Okay, one sec, bro. One sec, I need to heal. That's a big attack range.
Killing the level 1 bishop was ridiculously easy, but the level 2 knight on the other hand was nearly impossible to dodge. The order that ChatGPT wants me to fight these in is the wrong one, because the one that speedrunners usually do is knight first, then bishop, and the rook last. And that makes a lot of sense now, because the knight on level 2 is actually ridiculously hard to dodge.
Damn, okay, football helmets are breaking left and right. Oh my, this is... I did not underprepare, I actually did not at all. I'm just bad at the kiting. That's exactly why I needed to overprepare, down to my last two pieces of armor. Sorry. This is not fucking gonna happen.
On the third attempt, I managed to kill the level 2 knight and only the rook was left, but I started overheating and in the end, the rook killed me.
The rook.
And then there was attempt 6.
Can I tank it? Oh wait, that's way better, what the fuck? Bro, he's already like... And he's already dead! What? Why didn't I do this before?
The rook is the toughest and should be dealt with last.
I can only dodge him. I need a speed boost to be able to dodge him. This is the...
Speed boost.
And now I can abuse this. He almost wiped out the whole pack. Oh, there goes the beefos. There they go. The whole pack is dead. But so is the rook. So is the rook. Come on. And it's dead.
After nearly 4 hours, I finally killed the shadow pieces, and it was time to move on to stat 3.5. But don't worry, this is gonna be a short one again. The only meaningful things I did were killing the Lord of the Fruit Flies and expanding my pig farm by running around the world, destroying pig houses, and nearly getting turned into fried chicken several times. And don't forget to mention the bird that caught on fire. But do you wanna know what's cool? Like, really cool? That's right, killing the ancient Fuelweaver. So I started preparing according to all ChatGPT recommends.
It's time to summon and defeat the ancient Fuelweaver. Step 4, summoning the ancient Fuelweaver. Weapons, dark sword, ham bat, or Thule side club. Armor, Thule side crown, football helmet, log suit, or marble suit. Healing, honey poultice, healing salve, pierogi.
Dragon pie.
Sanity, taffy, jerky, or tam o'shanter. Light, lanterns, miner hats, glow berries, or light bulbs. Food. Bring high nutrition, non-perishable foods like jerky and honey ham. Ancient key and shadow atrium, necessary to activate the gateway.
Now I need to find the atrium.
Steps to find the atrium. 1. Locate a sinkhole, prepare for descent, equip yourself with light sources, food, armor, and weapons. Enter the sinkhole to descend into the caves. 2. Navigate the caves. Explore and map. Use your light sources to explore the cave system. Keep your map handy to avoid getting lost. Identify ruins entrance. Look for a deeper sinkhole within the caves that...
Yeah, no, that's how it works in the single player version, not Don't Starve Together. And also, the atrium is not in the ruins. Matter of fact, the way you get to it is by killing one of these big tentacles that can be literally anywhere in the caves, and then going through the wall home that's under them. And there is multiple of these tentacles in the world, so even if you found one and killed it, it could still lead you into a stupid rock biome. And that's when I had enough of this nonsense of just walking around with no direction, not knowing where to look, and not wanting to spend the next 2 hours just aimlessly walking around in the caves. So I asked my Discord server for permission to reveal my minimap.
I can't find the tentacle to the atrium. Am I allowed to reveal my map? Yes!
But even after revealing it, there was a slight issue. I still don't know how exactly I can get there, so I decided that I'll just abuse a glitch. I went back to my base, I cooked all of the food that I will need, and I made two gates that I need for the glitch. No, I actually forgot about those, and I had to go back to my base to prototype them. But this is how the glitch works for those who don't know. It's called void walking, and what you do is you place two gates on the edge of the world in the caves, open them, and then get to the edge yourself, and close the gates. They will push you into the void, and you can walk around there freely. And once you need to get back on land, just open the game menu, go to server commands, and click rescue me, which puts you on the nearest piece of land. And now I'm here, in the arena. Let's summon it.
Activate the gateway. Once you find the atrium and the ancient gateway, use the ancient key to activate it. This will prepare the gateway for the summoning ritual.
ChatGPT forgot to mention one thing. You need to build a skeleton in which you put the shadow atrium using fossil fragments.
It should have mentioned it, bro. It should have been mentioned. And now, do I give it? Okay.
Tips for the fight. Destroy bone cages. Break free from bone cages quickly to avoid being trapped.
No.
That's right. ChatGPT said destroy the cage. Destroy the cage. Yes, destroy the cage.
Oh, damn it. Oh my god, I can't do anything with it. I can't get out, I just have to fucking tank it, I think. This wasn't a part of the contract. This wasn't a part of the contract. Help! 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 This wasn't in the contract. What the fuck? You cannot even let us end it. No, sir. No!
Focus on minions. Quickly eliminate any woven shadows summoned by the Fuelweaver.
I can't let him get in. He's fucking... Oh my god! Oh, and he's getting fucking... They're feeding him! You stupid goblins! Oh my god, bro. I swear the guy is putting me in the cage just because I'm autistic. I don't give up. Oh, is it shielded? What do you mean it's shielded? Oh my god, last full Bahamut. Last full Bahamut. Oh, I'm out of... Can't heal. No.
That did not work at all, but let's try it again.
I forgot to bring up my sanity.
Manage sanity. Counteract the unseen hand attack that drains sanity.
Get me out of here! Oh my, no! ChatGPT, you suck. ChatGPT, you suck, you did not, bro. It definitely did not mention the laser explorer, it did not mention that. Like, this is easy to dodge, but not the... Or like the cage that's the ultimate against me. Oh god, stop putting me in cages, please! Oh... No! Oh my... No! He's cheating! He cheated! I can't heal anymore,
Apparently I was supposed to break the cage, but in reality I need to teleport out of it, and the only way to do that is by using the laser explorer. And after confronting that unreliable creature, after all of this, it gaslights me.
You're right! And now it's telling me how to assemble it!
I decided to try one last time, but this time I went in the ruins to get the laser explorer. After I made it, and got back to the atrium, it was time to try to kill the ancient Fuelweaver one last time.
What is that? What the fuck is this Matrix attack? Bro thinks he's a part of the Matrix, what the... Get your ass! Attack me! Like a man! Oh, I just teleported. I teleported straight to where he's hitting me. That was a bat. You will be. Shut the fuck up! Liar, Matrix agent, and all of that.
That's horribly timed. Oh my god, he has the... Stop eating it! Oh my god, no! Oh my god, 2000 health that he just gained the fuck back! Why is it shielded? Am I supposed to be insane so I can attack him or what? Oh my god, this is stupid, bro, this is... Oh my... Wrong! Here's the conclusion to the video. I'm too bad to fucking kill him. And my food is getting fucking delivered. Oh my... My food is getting delivered, bro. I'm sorry.
Now, there is a quote for this. Thy person with skill issue shall not beat ancient Fuelweaver, or some stupid shit like that. I don't have anything to blame my death on anymore, other than the fact that I just suck. Anyways, subscribe.